Okay, now we'll see about network configurations in Linux. So why do you need network configuration? You need network configuration because you need to exchange information via the internet or through your local LAN. Okay, so let's go on with that. RHC, okay, network configurations. So one of the method is graphical method, the other is the text based method. Okay, so you have two commands. You can either use neat or this big command, or you can use neat-tui or this big command. Okay, so it's better to be in root. Okay, so su into root and given enter and given your root password. After that, what you could do is type in neat. A GUI will open up for you. Just click on that and click on edit. You can given the nickname for this particular interface, then given the IP address, what you want to give, given the subnet mask and the default gateway, then click on OK. This is not a network class, so I'm not going to dive into the IP addresses, so I'm going to close out of this. Okay, and I'm going to close out of this as well. If you want to do it via command line, neat-tui, enter, so you can hit on that, hit enter, so you can change the parameters here. So if you want to add a new device, what you could do is you can go there. Okay, before adding up a new device, I would like to show this particular stuff of sbin if config. So you could see that I have an IP of 1.11 associated with eth0. I'm going to assign another IP address to eth0:1. That is basically like splitting my interface. Okay, I'm going to hit on enter. That's an Ethernet interface. My the name is going to be eth0:1. I'm going to use a static IP address of 192.168.1.100, subnet mask of 255.255.255.0, 192.168.1.1. Hit on OK. Hit on save. Hit on save and quit. Okay, then if I were to type if config, I'll not find that because I need to hit service network restart. So once that is done, let me hit on clear. If config, enter. So you can right now see that Ethernet 0:1 is also activated. At the same time, eth0 is also up and running. Okay, so that's for this. Then you can use ipadd command to view the IP configurations. Okay, ipadd command. Okay, or you can use ifconfig command as well to view the IP address configurations. Then MII tools, if you just give in this command and hit on enter, it will tell whether your Ethernet is established or not. And on this particular machine, I have not installed this particular tool. Probably once I install this tool, I'll try to cover up this one. It's not a very big deal if this MII tool is installed. Just given this particular command and hit on enter, it will tell if there is some error in your connections. So with the W, there should be a space, I guess. With hyphen W, it watches your system continuously. I do have it. Sorry. So it does tell that the link is okay. Okay. Then if I were to type mii-tools-w. Then mii-tools-w. Okay, now it's watching my Ethernet. I'm going to pull out my Ethernet cable. I hope it will detect it. It has not detected it yet. Okay, I found out why it did not detect it, because I am inside some other machine. I have to remove the cable manually. Okay, let me show it to you while I'm doing that. Click on OK. So that no link. Now I'll try to add up the link once again. Network adapters. Let me click on cable connect. Click on OK. It should bounce back up automatically. Yeah, it did come back up. Okay, so that's how you check with the help of MII tools. And be aware that you need to be root to do that. Okay, if not, it is not going to work. Then hit Control C to exit out of that. Then I have explained about service network restart as well. So that completes the network configuration. And after this, you can open up your browser window. Okay, I'm going to point at my default gateway 192.168.1.1. It's asking for my DSL router's username and password. So I'm pretty much sure that my network is configured right now. Okay, thanks a lot for viewing this video. Bye bye.